Well, welcome back to the work truck this time. So glad that I put on that cutting edge and deflector the other day. Because later on that night, you guys, it snowed and went crazy. And it was heavy and it was a deep snow. And it was a heavy wet snow because the temps here that afternoon on Friday were mid-30s. So we had 35, 36, and the snow started. So it was that heavy wet snow. And then it went all night Friday night. And I went out at 1 a.m. and tested this new cutting edge, and it worked great. We ended up with like 10 inches of snow over the weekend from Friday night all the way into Sunday. And I was out most of that time. I got like a couple hours of sleep. I didn't get any real sleep till Sunday night, but from Friday to Sunday, I think I slept 12 hours, something like that. I can't, or 2 hours, something like that. But that's how it is here in Michigan in the winter. I can't wait to get back into the workshop, but I've been just after that whole big event. The plow worked great. The cutting edge makes it real nice again. Feels like a brand new plow again. The deflector kept everything off the windshield, so that was good. And now I'm just running around checking the jobs. So I'm just going over, making sure everybody's cleaned out. There was so much drifting because it was so windy on Saturday, and the temperatures dropped. So now we're sitting, nighttime we're below zero. Right now it's 16 degrees, and it's just before noon. So like I said, I'm running around checking the jobs, making sure all my edges are pushed back. We lost a lot of trees, a lot of tree limbs in the area because of that Friday night when the temperature was still pretty warm out. You know how that wet, heavy snow gets? It just gets, it tugs on those branches. So there's a lot of branches laying all around. All those are pretty much cleaned up. But in the spring, we're going to have to do a lot of trimming and, making everything look better and cut them off properly. Right now, I'm just in the neighborhood checking jobs, making sure, everybody's good, and haven't had any phone calls. So we had a little bit of light snow this morning. Nothing to plow, just that little light stuff that accumulates. And it's so cold too right now that salt doesn't work, so we can't even throw salt down on these paved roads and these subdivisions or whatever. So they kind of feel like dirt roads right now because there's that layer of ice underneath, and then we have this fresh fluffy snow on top, and it's not slippery, it's just bumpy now and hard as a rock. So I think we're staying in this cold spell like this for the next, at least another, till I think next Tuesday of this month. So another week of this real cold stuff, and then it looks like it gets warm again, back in the 30s. So it's not really what I want. I want it to stay winter. If it's going to be winter, stay winter, because we want to do some ice fishing. So, speaking of ice fishing, my video that I put out, what is it, last year, 2 years ago, something like that, I believe, the ice fishing, where I talked about the ice, upgrade the ice fishing. I'll put it here somewhere and you can see it and go check that out. But I can't wait to get back to ice fishing. Last year was not a good year for ice fishing. We had it stayed too cold or too warm. It didn't get cold enough. But February and especially March last year, man, did we get the snow. Holy cow, the snow and the cold in March last year. Right now, it's January. We've got 10 inches sitting on the ground here in Michigan, southeast Michigan. So I'm happy with it. It looks good. Here, I can turn this camera around and you guys can see. Check this out, this little neighborhood. So yeah, it can stay as winter like this as long as it wants. I like it. The sun is shining finally. We don't get a whole lot of sun here in Michigan in the wintertime, but we'll sure is pretty when we do get it. So the next project that I've got coming up, there's a few things I want to do. And the Coleman stuff, You guys, you saw that Coleman Coleman stove? Maybe I'll show you some of that Coleman stuff here soon. I have a lantern I want to work on. I have the 502 burner. That thing is really cool. And I've got a couple of the stoves, some two burners, some different ones, some older ones. So I really like those. And maybe we'll get into those because I am rebuilding them. Some need to be rebuilt, some don't. They just work. It's another cool thing that, old American-made stuff, man. Real steel stuff, right? None of this plastic China garbage. It was the old school stuff. So I'm into that stuff lately. I'm glad I didn't get rid of all of it, but some of it is gone. But anyway, I'll bring that old Coleman stuff back. Another thing I need to do to the truck is I have to change the back brakes and rotors next. So it's a little too cold in the shop and everywhere to do that right now. So the next warmer spell, that's when I'll do that. And I'll bring you in the shop for that. I did do the front end rotors, brakes, universal joint on the passenger side and ball joints on the driver's side. The truck's at 50,000 right now. So I just wanted to get that stuff freshened up. I changed the oil. I changed the transmission filter fluid, and that's all done now. That's another $50,000 50,000 mile recommendation, and that's done. So maybe I'll throw in some of those pictures of what I did on the brakes right here. Yeah, that's what I'll do. I'll give you guys some pictures of what I did on the brakes, and then I'll throw some audio in on that, and that will help bring some more stuff to this video for you. So I'll talk to you guys again real soon. Get into your workshops, fellas. But right now, I'll give you a little bit of B-roll of this beautiful neighborhood and what it looks like in the snow. Get in the workshop.